Ladies and gentlemen, last evening at a gala coronation ball held at the Manchester High School Gymnasium, several hundred people witnessed the crowning of Miss Golden Jubilee. She is Queen Susan McDonald, student at the Manchester High School, and the lovely daughter of Mr. and Mrs. R.S. McDonald. Queen Susan will reign throughout next week as Manchester celebrates its 50th birthday. We have with us at this time for an exclusive interview, Susan McDonald. Queen Susan, I'm sure that you're still excited over this big event.
Yes, I am very much excited over it.
I know that I'm sure that you wasn't prepared for this, but that I mean that I'm sure that anything like this, any contest that, of course, it's best to feel like, well, I'm not going to build up my enthusiasm too much because I may not get it. And then once it's just sprung on you and here you are queen. I know that you'll have a wonderful time during this week of as Manchester celebrates its Golden Jubilee. I would like to ask you a few questions. How old are you, Susan?
16.
You're 16, and what do you plan to do when you finish school?
I plan to go in some type of designing.
Uh-huh. And would you like to say something to all of the people out there that helped you become queen of the Manchester Golden Jubilee?
Well, Bill, I feel it is an honor, and I'm proud to be the queen of Manchester Golden Jubilee. I would love to express my appreciation to all my friends. I realize it wasn't luck, but friendship and the support of the wonderful people of Manchester and the surrounding communities. As Queen of the Manchester Golden Jubilee, I would like to extend to everyone a cordial invitation to the historical pageant and festivities of the following week.
Thank you very much, Susan. We might mention, too, the princesses, which will also reign in your court during this coming week. Gail Chapman, Martha Hankin, Claudette Moody, Joan Caldwell, Cynthia Pike, Charlene Royal, Joan Guy, and Martha Culpepper. They finished in that order, by the way. It was a very close race, and it was a wonderful contest. It really was. Susan, once again, would like to say congratulations to you, and we hope you have a joyous reign throughout the week. And you did mention that to everyone to come down to the big Golden Jubilee, all of our out-of-town listeners and so forth. Is that right?
Yes.
Well, that's fine, Susan. And we'll see you all of next week, of course, at the Manchester Golden Jubilee. Ladies and gentlemen, we interrupt this program to bring you a special broadcast from downtown Manchester, where the capsule time capsule ceremonies are being held. We take you direct to WFDR's Alert News Watch, Jack Whitehorn on the scene.
Thank you a lot, Bill Gerald. And right now we are in downtown Manchester in connection with the Manchester Golden Jubilee celebration and the burial of the time capsule. And right now, let's see if we can pick up the festivities that is happening right now.
Miss McGinney is proud to say that she'll be 74 years young her next birthday. The monument that will be placed over this time capsule was given inscribed with a date buried and date to be reopened by Thomas involved in mining company of Thomaston, Georgia, Mr. J.C. Brumlow, owner, and obtained through the efforts of Mr. James C. Eddy's Cox Funeral Home. A copy of our Holy Bible from the First Baptist Church. Papers to the master of the Masonic Lodge in Manchester at the time of the reopening, and many more items, but too numerous to mention, that will be of great interest to those who are up in these capsules. Now, it is a great pleasure for me at this time to present to you one of the leading citizens of our community, also serving as one of our city commissioners. I give you the Honorable Charles Gray, Sr.
Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, the time capsule that we are burying this afternoon is a symbol of our heritage and our faith in the city of Manchester, our rich heritage from the past, and our faith and confidence in the future. Manchester, named for an industrial center, Manchester, England, is now a community 50 years old and is an excellent example of our American way of life. We have watched with justifiable pride as our community grew from a railroad junction in the Pine Mountain area to a healthy, thriving, progressive Georgia community of today, which richly deserves the name of the Magic City. This time capsule, when it is opened in the year 2009 AD, will tell our children and our grandchildren of our celebration here, the Golden Jubilee of the City of Manchester. Each article that has been placed in this container will represent a phase of our celebration. There were so few people here in the year 1909 when Manchester became a reality. It was 2 square miles of hilly, rugged land, just a simple, meager little place in the road when it started out. Today, it is a clean, beautiful little city of around 5,000 persons. Who can tell what the story will be in the year 2009? Will this be a thriving metropolis of some 200,000 people? Will this be a mecca of the textile industry? Will a large paper plant in this area be a reality? What will it be like in the future? Only time, the measure of all that is living in the universe, of all that is gone, and all that will be, time alone will tell. Perhaps the next 50 years will bring the secret of the fountain of life that Foster Leon was seeking. Advances in science and technology during the past 50 years would be unbelievable to the pioneers of Manchester who have passed on some years ago. Today, as we enter the space age, science is on the brink of startling new discoveries in medicine, guided missiles, transportation and communication, utilization of atomic energy, and space exploration. We may see some of these things in our own lifespan, but it makes you stop, wonder, and think, just what? Who will open this container in the distant future year? It makes a man think and ponder, but let's hope that when the future citizens of Manchester look back on our generation and this capsule is open, they will look back with pride and appreciation on our heritage and freedom, our two most precious possessions, which we will always strive to pass on to them as a gift through time. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Bray, for those remarks, and I'm sure your words will inspire us to make a bigger and better Manchester. I would now like to call upon another leading citizen of Manchester, our city manager, Mr. Anderson Curtis, to say a few words.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to read a letter that the city will put in this time capsule. Along with this letter will be considerable data from the city, such as water rates, tax digest, a budget for 1959. To our colleagues of 2009, the city of Manchester, in its joyous Golden Jubilee celebration, looks with pride to the future. We have been handed the torch by our forefathers, of whom we are deeply grateful. Many of them have made footprints here that will never be erased. We can hear their high ideals and principles echoing to us from far away, saying, come, wait, pull together, and continue to build on the foundation that has already been laid, a city that the future generation can be justly proud of, a city that will be progressive, healthy, beautiful and friendly, a city well planned that will be inviting and admired by all. These responsibilities we sincerely accept. It is our endeavor to carry this torch high, where it can be seen by all men, giving off shining rays of honesty and integrity, and gleaming with the community spirit that has been described by some as most wonderful. Yes, we love our town. As we set the compass to the future, we take a look at the past, the point of beginning, in order to keep our line straight. As we set our stakes in the future, it will be a living symbol of combined effort to preserve that which is so dear to us all, the American way of life. In this path that is set before us, we seek thy divine guidance. If we have a request to pass on to you, it would be, may Almighty God lead you as he leads us. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. McCurdy, for your comments. Mr. Bray and Mr. McCurdy, we are making a tape recording of this ceremony, and I'm sure your children and grandchildren will be quite thrilled when they hear your voice 50 years from today. I would sincerely like to thank Mr. Mercy Bovington, Master Sergeant Yancey Butler, Mrs. David Pittman and her chapter, and those connected with the City of Manchester for their time and effort in this project. It wouldn't have been possible without them. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will seal the capsule and bury them beside our American Legion marker. We thank you for your interest and attendance. We would like to urge you to come by the Hospitality Center and see the things on display there. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the time capsule ceremonies here this afternoon in connection with the Manchester Golden Jubilee celebration. This is Jack Whitehorn with Mobile Unit Number 1 of WFDR's Electronic News Center, returning you now to our studios.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have just heard a live and direct report from WFDR's Alert News Watch, Mobile Unit 1, from the scene here in Manchester, Georgia, behind the community building where the time capsule ceremonies were held. This 6th day of May, 1959, a tape recording is being made of this broadcast, which will be also entered into the time capsule. The temperature reading outside, it's 92 degrees. The weather forecast for Manchester and vicinity, partly cloudy and warm weather will prevail today, tonight, and tomorrow. The high temperatures today should be up around 94 degrees, dropping off to a low tonight of near 68. Tomorrow, the temperature should climb back up to 88 or so. The barometric pressure reading, 29.85 inches of mercury and steady. Once again, the temperature reading, it's 92 degrees. WFDR on time at the chime, 22 minutes past the hour of 2 o'clock. We return you now to the program in progress, Sharon Castile and your Music at Random show.
The preceding program featured Mr. Jack L. Dean, chairman of the Time Capsule Ceremony. The first speaker, Mr. Claude A. Bray, Sr. Mr. Claude A. Bray, Sr. The second speaker, Mr. Ellis McCurdy, City Manager of Manchester, Georgia.
The Eskimo hop all around the saloon, with the caribou crawl and the grizzly bear hug, we did our dance on a Kodiak rug. The song she kept singing made a man's blood run cold. When it's springtime in Alaska, it's 40 below. I was as innocent as I could be. I didn't know that Lil was Big Ed's wife to be. He took out his knife and he gave it a throw. When it's springtime in Alaska, I'll be 6 feet below. When it's springtime in Alaska, it's 40 below.
Neighbors, I see that old clock on the wall has just about pushed us out again, so Pruitt, if you'll hit the theme, we'll get on that.
Well, friends, you've been listening to your Saturday Jamboree, good old country music designed especially for your Saturday morning listening pleasure. This Saturday's Jamboree was brought to you through the courtesy of Gene Brown's Prescription Store. Now don't forget the amazing new discovery that'll make your dog safe and comfortable around the house. That's Brown's Worm Capsules. If you can't get by the store now, don't forget to drop a card to Brown's Prescription Store in Manchester, Georgia, and the worm capsules will be sent to you immediately. We'd like to say once again thanks to the special guest we had on the program this morning, the Rebelettes, which consisted of Sandra Fulgham, Kay McRae, and Gay McRae. Pruitt Long, he started out as a guest on the show, but he's sort of become a regular, hadn't he, Joe?
That's right, Bill.
All righty. Well, friends, and we want to say thanks to you for tuning in on the Saturday Jamboree. We'll see you next Saturday at the same time. Until then, bye-bye.
Music in IFI on our 1370 Club this morning, the song entitled The Guitar Boogie Shuffle. It's 4 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock on the 1370 Club. The weatherman says partly cloudy and warm weather will prevail today, tonight, and tomorrow. The high temperatures today should be up around 88 degrees, dropping off to a low tonight of about 68. Tomorrow the temperature should climb back up to 88 degrees or so. 66 out there right now. Time to remind you that you're listening to your 1370 Club, music all on record, music in hi-fi, reaching you from 1370 on your radio dial, WFDR in Manchester, Georgia. We'll have more music for you in just 1 minute.
Prices and selection galore, high, high values at your friendly Belk store. Tomorrow's styles and the Belk guarantee, the store with more for the whole family. Yes, yes, more for less at Belk's.
Here's big Wednesday morning specials at Belk Gallant, Manchester's leading department store. Rimlet dish towels, values to 39 cents. This morning, while the last, five for $1. Cafe balances, some in Dacron, values to $1.59. This morning, just 26 cents. Lightweight woven cotton spreads, regular $2.49 value. This morning at Belk's, only $1.97. Here's another one. Lace paneling, needs no starching, no stretching, little or no ironing. $1.59 value. Going this morning at Belk's for only 97 cents. Be sure and take advantage of these and many other money savers at Belk's this morning. Remember to shop for your mother's gift at Belk's. Use Belk's convenient layaway plan. That's Belk Gallant, Manchester's leading department store.
Thank you.
Music and IFI on the 1370 Club to Song entitled Only You. It's 8 minutes, 20 seconds past 8 o'clock on the 1370 Club this morning. Say the time capsule ceremony will be held today at 2 p.m. The principal speaker will be Mr. Claude Bray Sr. The ceremony will take place behind the community center. This is in connection with the Manchester Golden Jubilee celebration in progress, of course, this week. And we might mention that this program that is on the air right now is being recorded to go in the time capsule. And we'd like to take time out to mention all of our personnel to be sure and get it on the recording. J.C. Lofton, our chief engineer. Sharon Castile, who will be along with you this morning at 9 o'clock for your morning blighter chatter. And let's see, there's Charlene Howard, our receptionist. And then, of course, Bill Gerald, who's going to speak to you in just a moment about something really important. And yours truly, Jack Whitehorn. Right now, let's hear Bill Gerald.
Let the weather get hot, as hot as hot can be. Will you care? You will not. No siree, for you'll be so
cool
and comfortable as can be with one of our air conditioners.
The cooling air conditioners.
Try one and you'll see.
You too can enjoy the year-round comfort of air conditioning with the new Fetters air conditioner from James Glazer's Radio TV Sales and Service in downtown Manchester. Yes, friends, you can enjoy breeze-cooled and dream-filled nights when your home is air-conditioned the simple, economical way with the new Fetters air conditioner from James Glazer's Radio TV Sales and Service. Fetters has a model to suit your individual needs for home or office and features the marvelous Four Seasons air conditioners that offers you year-round comfort. That's as automatic as the weather. This air conditioner heats, humidifies, cools, and dehumidifies. Whether you want the deluxe model or the less expensive custom models, you'll rest in cool comfort this summer and air-conditioned comfort all year round with a Fetters air conditioner from James Glazer's Radio TV Sales and Service in downtown Manchester. And while you're there, be sure and see the RCA Whirlpool automatic washers, valued at $259.95, going now for just $229.95. And listen to this bargain. An RCA Whirlpool refrigerator and freezer combination with automatic ice maker. You never have to worry with trays or water. You can buy it now at Glazer's TV Sales and Service for $100 off the usual price. Remember, too, that James Glazer's Radio TV Sales and Service has a complete line of stereo equipment, TVs, radios, and a complete line of household appliances. Go by James Glazer's Radio TV Sales and Service, the House of Sound, in downtown Manchester. Why don't you go by today?
You made me love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me want you. And all the time you knew it, I guess you always knew it. You made me happy sometimes. You made me glad. But there were times you made me feel so bad. You made me sigh for, I didn't want to tell you. I didn't want to tell you. I want some love. That's true. Yes, I do. Indeed, I do. You know I do. Give me what I cry for. You know you got the brand of kisses that I die for. You know you made me love you. give me what I cry for. You know you got the brand of kisses that I die for. You know you made me love you.
Music and I-Fi Music, but not King Cole. On the Capitol recording label, the song entitled You Made Me Love You, I Didn't Want to Do It. It's 14 minutes, 25 seconds past 8 o'clock on the 1370 Club, this May 6th, 1959. Look at the weather forecast for Manchester vicinity. Partly cloudy and warm weather will prevail today, tonight, and tomorrow. The high temperatures today should be up around 88 degrees, dropping off to a low tonight of 68. Tomorrow the temperature should climb back up to 88 degrees or so. Right now it's 66 out there, and it's more music and hi-fi on the 1370 Club. Music and I-Fi, music by Pete Fountain, the orchestra, the song entitled My Inspiration, 17 minutes right now past the hour of 8 o'clock as we move right along with more music and hi-fi on the 1370 Club.
All I want in this creation, a pretty little wife and a big plantation. Hey, black-eyed Susie.
Hey, pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black-eyed Susie. Susie is a daisy. She's so pretty, she drives me crazy. Hey, black-eyed Susie.
Hey, pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black-eyed Susie.
Susie went out huckleberry picking.
Her dad got got mad and he gave her a licking. Hey, black eyed Susie. Hey,
pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black eyed Susie. Whoops. I asked her to be my wife. She came at me with a Barlow knife. Hey, black eyed Susie. Hey,
pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black eyed Susie.
Though he loves his Susie baby,
love my biscuits sopped in gravy. Hey, black eyed Susie. Hey,
pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black eyed Susie. Make me happy, two little boys to call me happy.
Name one
sop
and name one
gravy.
One's gonna sop
and the other gonna save it. Hey, black eyed Susie. Hey,
pretty little Susie.
Hey, pretty little black eyed Susie.
Susie.
Music and Hi-Fi on the 1370 Club, a song by Tennessee Ernie Ford on the Capitol recording label entitled Black Eyed Susie. More music after station identification.
This is Hi-Fi Radio. For the best in radio listening pleasure, it's High Fidelity Radio, WFDR in Manchester, Georgia. WFDR, it's instant radio, just add volume.
Streets. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets on the day you say I do, and I say the same to you. There'll be laughter in the town. All the folks will come from miles and miles around. There'll be music in the air. Happy people gaily singing everywhere. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets on the day you say I do, and I say the same to you. You and I won't be amiss if we hide away and steal a little kiss. And through all the years ahead, we'll recall the happy day when we were wed. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets on the day you say I do, and I say the same to you. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets. Oh, they'll be dancing in the streets on the day you say I do, and I say the same.
Music and Hi-Fi on the 1370 Club this morning. The Ames Brothers, they'll be dancing in the streets. It's 23 minutes, 45 seconds past the hour of 8 o'clock. 76 degrees, the present street level temperature in downtown Manchester. Let's move right along with more music and Hi-Fi on the club this morning. The song entitled, I Can't Get Started. Music and IFI, music by Janice Harper on the Capitol recording label. The song entitled Let Me Call You Sweetheart. It's 28 minutes right now past the hour of 8 o'clock. Our latest reading from WFDR's Weather Tower, 76 degrees, the present street level temperature.
What store in town has the very best in shoes?
A.J. Sauls
has the very best in shoes. What store in town has better values too?
A.J. Sauls
has better values too. So say it again, where's the best store for shoes?
A.J. Sauls in downtown Manchester. Shoes in every style at A.J. Sauls. This week, A.J. Sauls has special prices for the most beautiful shoes in the world. Valentine shoes. After wearing those old-timey shoes, you'll be wanting your feet to feel as comfortable as possible. And that's what you get from Valentine shoes at A.J. Sauls in downtown Manchester. Go by A.J. Sauls this week and see all the latest styles. You'll find every size and width from 4 to 10. That's A.J. Sauls in downtown Manchester, Georgia. Remember, be sure and visit A.J. Sauls this weekend and pick out your new styles in shoes.
What store in town has the very best in shoes?
A.J. Sauls
has the very best in shoes. What store in town has better values too?
A.J. Sauls
has better values too. So say it again, where's the best store for shoes?
At A.J. Sauls in downtown Manchester, Georgia. This is High Fidelity Radio, Hi-Fi Color Channel 1370 on your radio dial, WFDR in Manchester, Georgia. 32 minutes right now past the hour of 8 o'clock, 76 degrees, the present street level temperature in downtown Manchester. Jack Whitehorn, your musical host on your 1370 Club, as we continue with more music in Hi-Fi.
Simply because you're near me. Funny, but when you're near me, I'm in the mood for love. Heaven is in your eyes. bright as the stars we're under. Oh, is it any wonder I'm in the mood for love? Why stop to think of whether this little dream might fade? We've put our hearts together, now we are one. I'm not afraid if there's a cloud above. If it should rain, we'll let it, but for tonight, forget it.